Steve Dotto here with another quick tube tutorial. I received an email, or actually a post on our comments area in YouTube, from a viewer who said that he loves the fact that I show you how to use all of these different great add-ons into my web browser. But then he says, how do I clean things up later? I'm getting too much stuff in my browser, and so how do I clean up after I experiment with the stuff that you've said is good, and then I decide I don't want to keep anymore. And it's really simple. It's something you should probably do on a fairly regular basis. We'll do it first in Chrome, and then we'll take a look at doing the same sort of thing in Firefox, and finally in Safari for those of you on a Mac. But it's all going to be very similar. In Chrome, what we do is we go into the Chrome settings, go into our preferences, and right there we will find extensions. That's what they call all of the little add-ons that I have within Chrome. And they appear either in my email software or they appear here in the menu bar. And you can see here are all of the different extensions that I have downloaded and demoed over the last little while. And oh my gosh, I showed a lot of stuff and a lot of crap too. But here's what you do, is you go through and if it's enabled, it will be active. And if it is enabled, it'll be taking up active memory, and unless you're using it, it should not be enabled. Now, if it's something that you just want to use occasionally, there's no harm in unenabling it, if that's a proper word, or turning it off here, and then just going back and turning it on when you want to use it. I don't mind leaving that extra little bit of space. But some of them, you can just delete if it's something that you're never going to use again. So I've got all these in here mainly because they're different things that I've tested before and shown. And I keep them in here but unenabled personally in case any of you ask me a question about it in the email forum and or in the discussion forum. This gives me an opportunity to re-enable it, look and try and figure out the answer if it's something that I don't readily know. So that's why I tend to have a little bit more than I probably should. But you see that very few of them are turned on. Just ones that I'm actually using are actually turned on. So that's where you manage your extensions in Chrome. Let's pop over into Firefox and have a look at how we do it there. Now, I tend to use Firefox a little less, or a lot less actually, than I use Chrome. I pretty much stay with Chrome, but I use Firefox for testing and I use it for some of the other account things that I work on. So I don't have quite as many extensions installed in Firefox, but if you do use Firefox and you want to manage your extensions, the place we go is here under the Tools menu. You go into Add-ons, and then within Add-ons, you can get all of your extensions and add-ons for the Firefox browser. So you see that I've got the Evernote Web Clipper, which I have on everything, LastPass, which I use on everything, MeasureIt, and are the ones that I have here. And I see that the video player Views has a toolbar that it installed, obviously, when I installed it, and it is disabled. Now, one thing you got to be careful of, when you install different web apps, sometimes they will install plugins in your browser. The other thing that they will do occasionally is they will change your search preferences and change from, for example, your default search engine being Google, it will often change it to Bing or Yahoo. It's something that I find very offensive and irritating. So just pay attention. And after you've installed a few apps, it's not a bad idea to check and see exactly what extensions you have plugged in. So this is where we access the extensions in Firefox. Now let's have a quick look at how we do it in Safari, just because we're here. Now in Safari, they kind of fool you. They fake you out in going in to check your extensions. When we go under the Safari menu, they've got Safari extensions right here, which is nothing but a promotional piece to tell you where you can go to get new extensions. Instead, you have to go into the preferences, and within the preferences, you click on the extensions tab here, and that brings you into your list of extensions, which allows you to install, uninstall, turn them on and off, and manage them. So three different places in three different browsers, but nevertheless, something that you should be doing on a regular basis, going through cleaning out any extensions that you're not using. Your computer will run faster and you will draw less resources. So it's a good idea to do a spring cleaning a couple of times a year on your extensions. I'm Steve Dotto, and I hope you found this tutorial today to be useful. If you have, please consider subscribing to our channel here. There's actually three ways that you can engage with us here on Dotto Tech. You can subscribe to this YouTube channel, which means that you hear about all of our videos as soon as they are made public. You can also sign up for our newsletter, which means you not only get a digest each week of all of the videos that we create in our once-a-week email, but you're also notified of any webinars or any special events that are coming up or any contests where we're giving stuff away. We don't typically sell stuff on Dotto Tech, but you'll be told about our free webinars and allow you to sign up early for them and that sort of stuff by joining our newsletter. And finally, If you are so inclined, I would encourage you to take a look at our Patreon page. Dottotech is primarily supported by you, our loyal viewers, through a crowdfunding service called Patreon. Have a look at the just click on the Patreon link, have a look, and see if it's something that you might be interested in participating in. And I appreciate you considering it. That's all the time I have for today. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.